All right, guys, welcome to a little tuning session. We're going to be going over the data from the recent dyno on the new setup with the 351. If you've seen that video, you know I was varying the boost a little bit, and I also changed the ignition timing. So I've got some important numbers here that I wanted to share with you that sort of explain how efficient the setup is and sort of where the inefficiencies are in the power band. And also the impact that ignition timing and varying boost levels have on the power output. So I've put together this spreadsheet and I'm going to go through it now. At 4,500, I turned the knob, so we jumped up to the second stage. So we went from about 12 PSI to 17 PSI. And in run 5, I jumped up from, I left it on the third stage of boost, so in this case it'd be about 22 PSI, and then I jumped up to no wastegate line, which is excess of 30 PSI. So you can kind of see the difference there on the boost. So in purple you have the higher boost line, and then in green you have the lower boost line. Obviously I wasn't leaving the wastegate alone, otherwise it would have come up to the set boost level and gone flat across, relatively speaking. But this gives us a big difference in boost from each pole, so we can kind of calculate the horsepower and what that does. Now, if you look at the other two lines here, the load, now this is calculated by the ECU and it incorporates the airflow that it's seeing. It's somewhat of an arbitrary number, similar to VE, where you can fudge this number with any kind of changes to your calibration. So if something's not right, like the mass airflow calibration, you could see numbers that might not necessarily mean anything, but they do kind of tell you where the peaks lie. So I think that's the important thing to take away from here. And for the purposes of this, I also have shown the ignition timing. So we've got run 5, which is the lower line, this V here. And I like to pull out timing where the load peaks. So if you look here on this this plot, we've got a load peak somewhere in this 4,500 range, and actually I am going to make a change to bring the timing down around 4,500. In general, as the load goes up, you want the timing to go down. As the RPM goes up, you can add timing back in. So for the purposes of this dyno, we weren't really changing the timing much. You can see that the greatest difference here would be around 4,100 RPM. I was running 5 degrees of timing on run 5 and about 10 degrees of timing on run 2. So only about a 5 degree difference, and as the load goes up, the difference actually is pretty small there. So not a whole lot of impact from timing from what I would expect here. We'll get into that more later, but for now I want to show you the impact that this boost had on the horsepower. So this is the peak numbers, 569 horsepower at 4,500, and that was on the lower boost level. If you look here, you can see the peaks. So what I've done is I've taken the numbers at 4,000, 4,500, 5,000, 5,500, and then at 5,800, where this boost peaks here at 34.5 PSI. Just before letting off the throttle. Now, another thing I want to mention is that this engine was completely out of RPM. There was no, we could not rev it any higher because the valve springs, I'm assuming, weren't stiff enough to keep up. So if you've watched another video, you know I shimmed those. That was not enough. I had turned the rev limiter on around 6,300, and I told the guy to rev it until it wouldn't rev anymore, and we obviously never hit the rev limiter, so that was having valve float. So as far as that's concerned, I wanted to show the difference here. So again, here's the numbers. I've taken all of these numbers from 4,000 and then 4,500, 5,000, 5,500, and 5,800, where the peak is immediately before letting off. And I've calculated, I've taken the difference in boost, the difference in power, and calculated the percent difference. And you could see all the data here. I'm not necessarily gonna go through all this at this point, but I did put it in this chart. So this is the main thing I want to show you guys here, and this is what sort of explains everything in a nice, easy to understand manner. So if you look at this chart, on the y-axis on the left, we have the percent difference. And that is, I calculated the percent difference in boost and the percent difference in horsepower. So obviously boost is a multiplier of horsepower. So we would expect that theoretically to be a constant, but in this case, what I'm seeing is that the engine actually, in this particular setup, seems to get more efficient as the RPMs go up. So let me show you what I mean here. In this first 4,000 RPM pull, so in the second pull, I was obviously adding boost, so that's why these percent differences are higher. So we're comparing the second pull to the first pull, or in this case, as I explained earlier, it would be run 5 to run 2. So run 2 was ran, it's this blue line again, that's the lower boost level. And run 5 is this purple line, which would be when I flip the knob twice. So basically what we have is at 4,000 RPM, a 20% increase in boost resulted in a 7% increase in power. So what does that mean? Well, let's find the 40% increase in boost here at 5,500. So if this was a linear trend, meaning across the board, you add 20% in boost, do you get 20% increase in power? You would expect that if at 4,000 RPM, a 20% increase in boost netted a 7% increase in horsepower, then a 40% increase in boost would net a 14% increase in power. But actually, what I'm noticing is as the RPMs climb, in particular at 5,500, it seems to be responding much more positively to the boost. And as I showed you before, the timing doesn't necessarily explain that, because there's only, at 5,500, there's only a 3-degree spark angle difference. And honestly, I probably would have pulled more timing out had I not, and had I had time. I'll get to that again in the timing table. My tune wasn't set up to be able to do that. But basically, all I want to show you here is that this particular setup, 4,000 RPM is the torque peak, 4,500 RPM is the horsepower peak. And in both cases, a big increase in boost, relatively speaking. So in this 4,500 RPM range, 33% increase in boost only gave 7% increase in horsepower, where at 5,500, a 38% increase in boost gave a 26% increase in horsepower. So what that tells me is that this engine, this setup, wants more boost in the high RPM range than it does in the low. And I find that to be a little bit counterintuitive, because if we look at the peak numbers, they occur, again, the torque peaks around 4,000, the horsepower peaks around 4,500. You can see that here, the first pull, we get a max torque of 698 foot-pounds at 4,000 RPM, and a max power of 569 at 4,500. So I found it to be a little interesting that the peaks don't follow the engine peaks, but in any case, the data is what it is. So stay tuned for the next video, we'll go through timing.